So Apple just actually brought Dolby Atmos Spatial Audio as well as lossless streaming to Apple Music for, guess what, no additional charge. So in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to enable both of these new features, as well as doing a listening test on my very own AirPods Max right here. So folks, let's do this. Hey Warenoticers, Shane here, and welcome to another video on the Warenotice Technology YouTube channel. If you're new here, definitely take a moment to consider subscribing so you don't miss out on all my other awesome tech videos about things like smartwatches, smartphones, tech accessories, computers, tablets, and really just so much more. Also guys, we just hit 4,000 subscribers today on the Warenotice Tech YouTube channel, so thank you all so much for that. I really do appreciate it, and I've been working so hard to put out a lot of videos recently. If you guys couldn't tell, I've been trying to get out a video like every day for the past couple weeks, so that has been very fun. My goal is to hit 10,000 subscribers by the end of the summer, so guys, let's make that happen. Anyway, now let's dive into this video. So in order to use these new Apple Music features, you need to have the latest software on your Apple device. That's going to be at least iOS 14.6, at least tvOS 14.6, at least iPadOS 14.6, you definitely get the gist there, or at least macOS 11.4. Once you're sure your software is up to date, we can go ahead and enable Dolby Atmos Spatial Audio, which, if you're unfamiliar with it, essentially allows your music to sound like it's coming at you in all different directions in a three-dimensional environment instead of in typical stereo audio, which sounds like it's either coming from the left or the right or both. So believe it or not, you can actually listen to spatial audio in Apple Music on any pair of headphones. You don't just have to have the AirPods Max, for example, or you could also listen to it on your Apple device's built-in speakers if you have one of these compatible Apple devices. I have a list of them right here on the screen, so you could check that. So now that you know that, we are ready to actually enable spatial audio on my iPhone 12 Pro Max here. So now to do that, you're gonna wanna open up settings, and then you're gonna wanna tap music, and then you're gonna wanna tap Dolby Atmos right here, which again, Dolby Atmos spatial audio, those words are pretty much interchangeable on iOS right here. So as you see, your options for enabling spatial audio in Apple Music are automatic, always on or off. I personally have mine set to automatic, which means that Apple Music will use spatial audio if you're listening to a compatible song on it and either on the built-in speakers of one of those aforementioned devices or on one of the select Apple or Beats headphones that is set up to automatically use spatial audio as well with automatic enabled. Otherwise, if you want to use any pair of headphones, which once again I said you could use, you're going to want to tap always on. So it says that is not supported on all speakers, but once again, don't worry, it does make the note that you can connect to headphones, which once again, could be any pair of headphones or Dolby Atmos supported speakers for the best experience, it says. So turn on and boom, now you can listen to Dolby Atmos spatial audio on whatever headphones you want. So since I am going to be using the AirPods Max, which are one of the automatic supported headphones, I don't actually have to leave always on. I can actually go right back to automatic and it should work just fine. Now, anyway, we can go back in the settings app. This is now how to turn on lossless streaming in Apple Music. And then we could tap on audio quality right here, and then we could turn on lossless audio right there. So now, as you can see on Wi-Fi streaming, it's got lossless. We can also go up to high resolution lossless, or we can bring it down to just high quality. So I'm going to personally leave mine just on lossless right here, because if we tap on high resolution lossless, you'll see that it says, quote, to play content in high res lossless at full resolution, you will need an external digital to analog converter, which I don't have. I'm just using wireless, beautiful AirPods Max right here. So we will leave that on lossless, and then downloads, that is on lossless as well. And then cellular streaming, you know what? If you wanna ball out, you can even turn that up to lossless right there. And it says that lossless streaming will consume significantly more data, but is what it is, stream lossless, and then boom, now that is all set up as well. And if you want to enable spatial audio and lossless streaming on the iPad's Apple Music, it's the exact same process, literally just settings, music, Dolby Atmos, I'll leave it on automatic, audio quality, turn lossless on, and then yup, on Wi-Fi and on downloads, we've got lossless, and boom, super easy right there. So now let's actually take a listen to some of this. I've already been listening to a bunch of different songs in spatial audio, so I've already started to form an opinion on it. Now, one thing that I think is very cool is over here in the browse section of Apple Music, where I am right now, they actually have all these different spatial audio contents right here, since spatial audio did just come out for Apple Music. So for example, they have a bunch of different playlists with songs that they said are made for spatial audio in all these different genres. So we've got hits, hip hop, pop, country, classical, rock, jazz, all these different genres. And then we've also got like a demo right here that I've already listened to as well, where they explain spatial audio as well as demonstrate the sound differences between spatial audio, stereo audio, and mono audio. Once again, spatial, it's like 3D coming at you from everywhere. Like you have a surround sound system, stereo, that is left side and right side sound, and then mono, that is same sound on both sides. So yeah, you have that option right there. I encourage you guys to take a listen to that. So now for me personally, I've actually been listening to a bunch of different songs over here in the hip hop in spatial audio playlist to try to get an idea of the difference between spatial audio and stereo audio in Apple Music and the sound differences and can you really tell and all that sort of stuff. So I've been listening to this Kanye West song a couple different times right here. So now I'm playing it on my AirPods Max and you can tell that it is indeed in spatial audio because it says Dolby Atmos right here, which does in fact mean spatial audio. So one thing I like to do when I'm listening to a song in spatial audio to try to imagine the sounds in all different directions like they are supposed to sound is close my eyes and just really focus on it. So here we go. So now after listening to a couple of minutes of that, I will say obviously it sounds absolutely amazing because it's on these AirPods Max, it's streaming lossless, and it also is in spatial audio. But for me personally, I can't really tell a huge difference when I listen to spatial audio. The way I've heard Apple describe it, it sounds extremely amazing and mind-blowing. And just for me, it's not really mind-blowing. Now, for certain songs, I can sort of, you know, tell a difference when I go back and forth between spatial audio and regular stereo audio. Like, for example, I might notice in the spatial audio, like maybe drums playing behind me or instruments in different places, which is what you're supposed to notice, like instruments and vocals coming from different places around you. And yeah, sometimes I do notice that, but I wouldn't say it's like a huge difference unless I'm actually trying to notice it. But now don't get me wrong, I do really appreciate the spatial audio feature, especially given that Apple is giving it free to us. If you are already subscribed to Apple Music, it's not like you have to pay extra to listen in spatial audio right here. And yeah, I mean, since I've updated my different devices software and got the ability to use spatial audio in Apple Music, I have been listening to music only really in spatial audio besides when I'm going back and forth to really compare them. So I mean, I like spatial audio, but again, unfortunately, I just don't find it very mind-blowing, but it's cool we get it. So now if you're wondering how I quickly get out of spatial audio, you can actually swipe over here to get to your control center. Then you can hold down on the little volume indicator right there to access your AirPods Max, but then you can just tap spatial audio right here to turn it off. And then, yeah, now I'm in stereo and then I can go back and now spatial audio. And one thing I will say that I've noticed is the stereo is actually louder than spatial audio. So when you switch to spatial audio, it gets quieter when it is at the same volume. So that is definitely interesting right there. So you might have to turn up the volume a bit. But now folks, if that volume difference actually between spatial audio and stereo audio bothers you, there's actually a way to fix that. So you can actually head back to settings, back to the music area of it right here. And then you could turn on sound check right there. And I've noticed that makes the volume in stereo and spatial audio pretty much the same. But now folks, another thing too, if you're wondering how to actually tell if you're listening to lossless music in Apple Music now that we've enabled it, you can actually come over here to the song, the album, the whatever you want to call it, and you can see if you can listen to it in lossless, there's actually a little lossless indicator right here that says lossless. So we can tap on that and read more about it. It says lossless uses Apple lossless audio codec. And another thing too you'll notice right here for certain songs is something called Apple Digital Master, and we can read more about that as well. And it says Apple Digital Master start from 24-bit files and are optimized to bring the best sounding audio to Apple products. So yeah, that's pretty amazing. All this premium audio features we're getting for the same price with our Apple Music subscriptions. I think Apple Music's just a really great deal. I'm super happy I pay for it. And yeah, now if we go over to, let's say, a different song, so we can come over here. So this one has Dolby Atmos. We already know what that is. That's a spatial audio. It has lossless and it has Apple Digital Master. So that's great. And let's see, this one right here, just Apple Digital Master. And then let's see, if we can find one with nothing. Okay. Oh, actually Lossless right here. But I do really think that is very helpful that songs now have these labels telling you what audio quality you're getting, whether it's Lossless, Digital Master, or Dolby Atmos. So now to do a listening test of the Lossless audio quality. This is a Lossless song right here, Amigos song. We could tap Lossless and then we could tap audio quality settings to bring us back into settings right here. And now I can actually turn off Lossless right here. The song is still playing to actually compare back and forth Lossless and non-Lossless. So again, it is still playing. Now I could turn Lossless back on. And honestly, Lossless and non-Lossless sound like exactly the same to me. I can't really pick up a difference. But yeah, I will definitely stick with Lossless anyway, because I mean, why not have higher quality, even though I can't really tell the difference. So with that, guys, now you know how to enable Dolby Atmos Spatial Audio as well as Lossless streaming on your Apple Music. Definitely let me know down in the comments if you guys try out these features, if you notice a bigger difference with them than I did. And if you guys enjoyed this video, definitely be sure to smash that subscribe button and subscribe to the Warenotice Technology YouTube channel for more awesome technology videos just like this one. And yeah, guys, thank you so much for watching and thank you so much for subscribing. Bye.